Here we have a JSON encoded log file, and you can see it's a little bit difficult to read. Let's see what happens when we open it in LogViewPlus. We can see the log file format is automatically detected. We could use the default configuration, but let's dive in to understand what's happening under the hood. Using the parser wizard, we set the file name pattern that will connect this configuration with the log file being opened. Then we specify the JSON format and provide a sample log entry. Now here we have the actual format used to parse the log file. You can see that the configuration is also JSON with conversion specifiers used in place of the values. Let's reset this default configuration and start from scratch. I just need to identify the four fields that we care about: the timestamp, the log entry message, the source logger, and the log level. Everything else can be removed. All log entries in LogViewPlus must have the same metadata, so it's normal to remove some fields when creating a standard definition. The removed fields are still available when we search. They just won't be available in the log entry grid. Also notice that LogViewPlus has detected that this JSON log file is actually in the CLEF format, which is popular with logging libraries such as Serilog. This parser hint added to our message field will substitute variables found in the template to create a human-readable message. Now if I save our updated configuration and refresh the log file, and let me just quickly hide these debug log entries, we can see my JSON log entries formatted into a simple grid, which is much easier to read. The original JSON message for the selected log entry is pretty printed at the bottom. Also notice that because we use the Serilog clef parser hint, our message template has been processed with variable substitution. So that's a quick overview of how LogViewPlus can help you parse and display JSON log files, but LogViewPlus can do so much more. If you're curious, check out the features page on our website for more information.